the RBA governor has embarrassed Anthony Albanese by contradicting his comments that inflation was under control just hours after he said it. There was a bizarre spectacle today where the Prime Minister tried to claim his policies were putting downward pressure on inflation, when RBA economists have said the precise opposite. The central bank specifically said this week that government spending was keeping inflation high and stopping rates from falling. They couldn't have been any clearer, saying it was a significant reason why inflation wouldn't return to the target band of 2 to 3% until 2026. Yet the Prime Minister today tried to pretend this was nonsense. This wasn't even a case of the PM trying to spin his way out of a problem. He was literally in denial mode. Have a look.
OK, on inflation, the RBA has taken a shot at your spending, which is why rates aren't coming down. Are Australians facing higher rates for longer because of big spending federal and state budgets?
Well, that's not what they've said, Peter, with respect. And the truth is...
Well, this is the quote here from the RBA. Public demand is forecast to be stronger than previously expected, reflecting recent public spending announcements by federal and state governments. Are you saying they're wrong?
Yeah, that's very different. That's very different from the way that you characterised it, Peter. Inflation has a range of aspects, and that's why we've made sure we agree that inflation needs to be further moderated.
And by the way, Pete Stefanovic did a better job than any other journalist who interviewed the PM this morning, and he did the rounds. But as you saw there, Albanese denied government spending was pushing up inflation and claimed it wasn't what the RBA had said. Let's just have a look at that specific lie, because it is a lie, again.
Are Australians facing higher rates for longer because of big spending federal and state budgets?
Well, that's not what they've said, Peter, with respect.
In fact, it was exactly what the RBA had said, both in written and verbal statements. But it got worse. Economists and media outlets are concerned about the clash in views between the RBA and Treasury, that monetary and fiscal policy may not be working in tandem. The Fin Review today reported on a split between the RBA and the Albanese government over the economic outlook, after Treasurer Jim Chalmers on Wednesday disputed the central bank's assessment that the economy was still operating at an unsustainable pace. And the Australian's front page headline today is Treasurer's RBA Brawl, and it reports on the growing divide between Jim Chalmers and the Reserve Bank. We've been speaking about the RBA's criticism of government spending over the past two nights. Yet the Prime Minister had the hide to insist there was no divergence between the RBA and his government.
But the other thing we've done that is so important is we've made sure fiscal policy, budget policy works arm in arm with monetary policy.
Well, that's not working at all, because the RBA and Treasury are brawling at the moment.
That's not true, Peter.
Well, you're saying completely different things.
We agree that inflation... No, we're not. No, we're not. We're saying that inflation needs to continue to moderate, and we're saying that we are working towards that. That's why we're producing two budget surpluses.
But just hours after the Prime Minister's denial, his newly installed RBA governor gave a lecture in Armidale today where she reiterated that inflation was persistent and she may have to raise rates yet again. There have already been 14 rate rises, as you know, in the past 2 years.
It also noted that the growth of demand looks like it'll pick up over the rest of the year, although I have to say here there's considerable uncertainty about the outlook. It's very uncertain. The effect of this is that the board's expectations for when inflation will come back to the 2-3% target range has been pushed out, and we don't expect we'll get there now until the end of 2025, so that's over a year away. And this is why the board explicitly considered whether another interest rate rise was required to ensure that inflation continues to decline in a reasonable time frame.
Pretty strong comments there. Then there's a conflict too between Albanese and the RBA over whether the energy subsidies are reducing inflation. Well, Albanese insisted today that energy relief was lowering inflation. Have a look.
We're making sure that they're getting that cost of living relief, but we're doing it in a way so it's designed to put that downward pressure on inflation at the same time.
Again, another point RBA doesn't agree with. Their senior economist, Sarah Hunter, said just yesterday that the temporary energy rebates would not ultimately reduce underlying inflation.
So what the board are considering and trying to achieve is inflation sustainably back at the target. In terms of being a sustained return to target, that's not something that we can see coming from those particular policies because they are only legislated for 1 year. So they're, by their sort of nature, time-limited and temporary.
And that sentiment was also reflected by the Reserve Bank's own monetary policy statement. And I'll read it to you now. They say headline inflation is expected to moderate temporarily in the near term, owing primarily to one-off measures, including those providing cost of living to households. However, headline inflation is then expected to increase as energy rebates and as currently legislated before moving in line with underlying inflation once these temporary effects have passed. And you can see in their figures that headline inflation does tick up back up to 3.7% when those measures end, the subsidies end. Now, opposition leader Peter Dutton seized on this conflict today when he gave his press conference in Darwin.
Anthony Albanese had a train wreck interview this morning on Sky News. It's clear to me that he doesn't understand the basic economic principles, and you've now got a war between the Albanese government and the Reserve Bank governor. I know who I would back in that war. It would be the expert in the Reserve Bank governor.
Now, none of this is good for Australia's economic outlook. You want the government and the RBA working hand in hand to bring down inflation, not having this public clash over direction. There's no point having the RBA take money out of the economy only for federal and state governments to inject money back into it just to win votes. And the Prime Minister yet again today announced another policy to give childcare workers an extra $100 each. More money in people's pockets. Inflation is keeping our interest rates high and cost of living high. And the least that state and federal governments can do is stop the cash splash.